I want to ask you a question. If the British government imposed a law today that stopped Muslims from practicing the fullness of their religion according to their customs, and if it said that anyone who converts to Islam should be killed, and if it said that you had to pay protection money for your life and property, if they imposed that law on Muslims, would you be complaining about discrimination, yes or no? So shall we talk
that
now?
Was a shouting
shall we talk now?
Yes.
Okay. Let's compare.
No, you want to talk. Wait, you are a dictator.
So I challenge you to a debate.
No, you cannot.
I'm challenging you to a debate.
You cannot.
Or any Muslim.
We have a master.
Any Muslim here.
Okay, come on.
I want to challenge you to a debate.
No, absolutely.
Let's compare the practices of ISIS.
No, let's compare
with the last acceptable caliphate that you believe was genuinely Islamic.
Can I speak?
You choose the caliphate. And then we'll compare it to ISIS and see what we discover. Which caliphate do you want to compare ISIS to?
I
want to
talk about
which
Muslims.
One?
When Muslims were ruling Spain.
Okay, that's the caliphate. Let's compare it to that one.
Okay. Muslims, they were ruling it for 1,000 years or something.
Not true, 700.
700 years, almost 1,000 years.
No, it wasn't.
It's almost 1,000 years. Anyway,
300 years off, I think.
If you round it up. Anyway,
rounding up 300 years, that's a long way.
Now, anyway, listen here. Muslims are ruling over 700 years with the Sharia. Okay?
With the Sharia, yes.
And
yes.
They introduced the concept of tolerance to Europe.
No, they didn't.
The ones that invited the Muslims to Spain was the Jews.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, the Jews were being persecuted by these Christian maniacs who were burning people at the stake. And they invited the Muslims to invade. Muslims, they came, they liberated the land. And they governed it with justice.
We liberated it by invading.
Yes, that's what you call it in America, man. It's called regime change. You call it regime change. If we do it though, you won't accept it. Anyway, ruled it 700 years here with justice, right? And then, what happened? The Christians retook the land. When the Christians retook
the
land, they did Inquisition. They started to kill all the Muslims. They started to go back to the old ways, started to kill all the Jews. And the Muslims ran away. They ran away to Islamic North Africa. They ran away to Morocco. And the Jews, where did they go? The Jews, they ran away to Islamic North Africa. They ran away to Morocco. Even Jewish scholars will tell you the Muslims are the one who saved Jews from genocide.
Can I reply?
Let me finish my point here. The Jewish scholars right now, they will tell you that the Muslims are the ones who saved the Jews from genocide at the hands of the Christians. And that's how they ran out in Islamic North Africa, there was Sharia. In Spain, there was Sharia. Yeah. And they weren't being persecuted, they weren't being killed, they weren't being massacred. And that was the height of enlightenment, that was the golden age for the Muslims. Were you calling it the dark ages?
Okay, shall I now reply? Or shall I just talk over you again? You've been talking a while, you've made your point, I get your point. Andalusia was apparently liberated it from the Nasty Christians, essentially is his point. Here's what he forgot to tell you, is that the Islamic occupation of Spain was started by an invasion, not a liberation. They were not invited by the Jews. The Jews had no sovereignty to invite anyone to a kingdom that was established by Christians, that was ruled by Christians, and who, incidentally, the very existence of the Jewish community evidences the fact that this kingdom was tolerant. The Jewish community existed there. Now, is it comparable to 21st century British multiculturalism? No, it isn't, of course not. The Muslims invaded a Christian community and conquered it by force, and then instituted Sharia law, as he says, which apparently is justice. But here's Islamic justice. Islamic justice and the concept of dhimmitude makes Christians and Jews second-class citizens. If you don't believe me, ask the martyrs of Cordoba. Because you see, this brother doesn't know about the martyrs of Cordoba. Because all he does is read an Islamic pamphlet that says how wonderful Andalusia is, and he never actually picks up a history book. The martyrs of Cordoba were killed by the Islamic State simply for the practice of their faith. When the Muslims invaded Spain, They went to the north of Spain and they desecrated churches. They desecrated churches in the north of Spain. They desecrated churches in Spain. They forcibly converted churches to mosques as a way of humiliating the Christian community. They banned Christians. They banned Christians from celebrating their festivals in their own country according to their own customs. And they imposed upon them. They imposed upon them a tax known as the jizya tax. The jizya tax is the state equivalent of mafia protection rackets. It essentially goes, you pay us or we take away your life and property. This tax subjected the Christians and the Jews to second-class status.
That's God telling you to shut up. Look here, the time he speaks here.
Whose light is it? Whose is it?
The time
I'm just catching this dude, I'm not finished.
The time in which you speak, right? And the time in which I speak here.
No.
Why
did
your time have to be longer?
Second, right?
Is that Christian justice?
You'll find that you've been speaking quite a while.
No, that's not true.
So, finally, if they ruled it with justice, what he forgot to mention was that the Islamic invasion of Spain signaled 700 years of constant confrontation, invasion, and attacking of their Christian neighbors. 700 years, raiding and taking slaves.
Can I respond?
700 years of aggression.
The monologue.
The reconquistador, of Spain was a liberation. He didn't mention the anti-Jewish pogroms in Andalusia. He didn't mention that. How 5,000 Jews were murdered in a single week because the Muslims were so offended that two Jews should be given positions of authority above the Muslims. Your reply.
Okay, number one, this guy, he said about the jizya tax, that the Muslims somehow are persecuting Jews or Christians, making them pay a tax, which is not fair. That's not true, okay? It's actually blatantly false on his face, because the Muslims, they had to pay a tax as well. The Muslims, they paid as a cat tax, okay? So in any society, in the UK, in Germany, any society you live in, every citizen has to pay tax. The Jews and the Christians, they don't pay the zakat tax. They have their own specific tax, which is called the jizya, okay? And the Muslim, when he pays that zakat tax, he has to serve in the military, okay? Military conscription was part of the deal, okay? He has to fight and die for the state, okay? The Jews and the Christians, they are exempt from military service by paying that. The Christian woman, and the Jewish woman, she does not have to pay nothing. Do you hear that? The Christian woman and the Jewish woman does not have to pay jizya. Even the Christian and the Jewish man who's not able to pay it does not have to pay it. It's only the one who's able to pay it financially. He's the only one that has to pay it. And the one that is unable to pay financially, even the male, which is unable to pay financially, he gets aid. He gets welfare from the states. So this is complete lies that you're uttering, okay? Saying, oh, jizya tax applies to all the Christians and the Jews. That's only a single point. This is what he does, He raises a can of worms, and I only have time to respond to one. Okay, and then he thinks he's winning. But let me respond to all of the points you made, Just remind me again all the points you made.
No, this is your time.
Okay, you don't want to remind me. See, this is called insincerity from Christianity.
Insincerity.
Yes. Because if it was genuine, you'd be like, okay, I made this point in response to it. Anyway. So another point you made was about the Muslims, killing Jews, killing Christians. Again, blatantly false on his face. If the Muslims, were persecuting the Jews and they were harassing them and murdering them, why would they flee from the Christians and run to Muslim lands, in Morocco, in North Africa? Why? That is, again, false on his face. On this video, I'll put the description, I'll put a link where Jewish scholars, they will say, thank you, Muslims, for saving us. You're the ones who saved us from genocide. And say, look at Christians, why they hate Muslims. Why? At that time, Christians were burning each other alive on the stake, yes or no? They were saying, you are a heretic for whatever reason. You're a witch, you're this or that. And they burned them on the stake. Okay? So why would they not burn people who they thought, oh, you are responsible for killing Jesus or you don't believe in Jesus? Obviously, they will burn them as well. And they were burning them at the stake. And even Hitler, yeah, Hitler was a Christian, but he said, oh, he became atheist, whatever. But he came from a Christian background. And from that background was, one of the arguments of Hitler, yeah, was the Jews killed Jesus, etc. I can give you that evidence as well. One of the arguments used by Hitler to kill Jews.
That's true.
Christians, yeah, in their heart, from the antiquity, yeah, they hated Jews. They had this kill mentality when it comes to Jews.
Mind if I reply now?
The book was...
One second. That was one point you made, yeah? I know you made several points, but you don't want to remind me of any of your points.
You can come back to them when...
No, I don't want to come back to them because I know you're going to go on a mad one, yeah? I want to be able to respond to all the points you made. Okay, one more point, yeah? About this thing about... Because you're Christians, yeah? All the filth of the whole world, yeah? They want to capture it and then throw it at Muslims and say, oh, look, for example, now ISIS is the biggest boogie man. So all they want to get all the scum of the whole world, yeah, and throw it at ISIS and say, look, Muslims, ISIS, blah, 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 and they make it hype about it, yeah? Look, you guys are doing all the evil stuff, yeah? But the ones who... Okay, let's compare numbers. Okay, how much ISIS killed? The Syrian Human Rights Watch, Iraqi Human Rights Watch, they said altogether 30,000 people. Now, we don't like people being killed. We don't accept... We don't want anyone to be killed, okay? But 30,000 people, fine, fair enough. America, how many has they killed in Iraq only? 2 million. So it's comparing apples and oranges. You are the biggest devils, the biggest mass murderers, the biggest terrorists on the planet.
Is that your point?
No. Modern times.
So he made a number of points. Many of them are counterfactual.
Let me finish up with
you. He said that I was making it up about the martyrs of Cordoba. So I challenge everyone who's watching on YouTube to go and Google the martyrs of Cordoba. Go and look up the historical references of what happened to the Christians in Andalusia. The Christians in Andalusia were subject to a system of laws that relegated them to second-class citizens. They were not allowed to carry arms, but Muslims could carry arms. Muslims were not allowed to convert to Christianity in Andalusia, but Christians could convert to Islam. So this is second-class citizenship. Christians were not allowed to celebrate their festivals and do processions in the streets. They had their freedoms limited. Furthermore, do you notice it's interrupting?
No,
they had to wear distinctive clothes so that they could be identified as Christians. Does that remind you of anyone? Maybe Adolf Hitler and the Jews? Now, he said that Hitler was using a Christian argument for his attack on Jewish society. The fact is, this man doesn't understand National Socialism. National Socialism is based on ethnic superiority, and he was arguing that Jews were not human. It was not about religion for Adolf Hitler. Not about religion at all. This is the man who's never picked up a book. All of his arguments are based simply upon the silly kind of regurgitation of the same nonsense that the Islamic Dawah team do all the time in Speaker's Corner. Now, he said, I was making it up when I talked about the jizya tax. He said, oh, Muslims have to pay a tax as well. Yes, they do. But the sentence for not paying the zakat isn't that you lose your life. The sentence for not paying the jizya tax is that you do. The sentence for not paying zakat isn't that all your property gets taken from you. But the sentence for not paying the jizya tax is that you do. So this idea that somehow these things are comparable is complete nonsense. We Christians have experienced Sharia law in Eastern Europe and in Spain. This is our history. I'm not going to be told our history by a Muslim polemicist and a Muslim apologist. This is our experience.
Ignorance.
This is part of
ignorance.
Our cultural memory. We know it for ourselves, what it means to be a dhimmi in the Islamic State.
Okay,
now,
response,
I challenged this man at the beginning to
the
compare
quick response.
Andalusia to
response.
ISIS. And that's what he did. He brought up ISIS. Now, let's have a look.
You brought him up. You brought it up at the beginning.
Under the Muslims invaded Spain. ISIS invaded Syria and Iraq. The Muslims in Andalusia took slaves. ISIS in Iraq and Syria took slaves. In Andalusia, they subjected Christians to demitude and all that that entails and forced them to pay the jizya. ISIS imposed demitude on Christians and Jews in Iraq and Syria and forced them to pay the jizya. Andalusia, the Muslims were constantly at war with their neighbors. ISIS was constantly at war with its neighbors. Andalusia said that it was a caliphate. ISIS says that it's a caliphate. You see, his example of a good Islamic caliphate looks a lot like ISIS. Am I the only one that sees that?
There we go.
Now, I accept he does not agree with ISIS. Fine, he rejects ISIS. Fine, I believe him. I believe him. But he does accept all the criminality that ISIS performed if the Andalusian Muslims did it. So if the Andalusian Muslims did it, it's okay. But if ISIS does it, it's wrong. Now,
you spoke for longer than me, Mark.
Fight those who believe not in Allah nor the last day.
This guy said, okay, the world.
No hold that forbidden which has been forbidden. This is my last point. Fight those who believe not in Allah nor the last day. No hold that forbidden which has been forbidden by Allah, his prophet, nor acknowledge the religion of truth. So you fight them because they don't believe.
Context.
Of the people of the book, that's Jews and Christians, until they pay the jizya with willing submission and feel themselves subdued. My final point is this. Let's reverse it. Let's say that the Muslims should be forced to pay a tax, failure to which would mean that they lose their life and their property, and they feel themselves subdued. If Britain tried to impose that law upon Muslims today, they would be screaming Islamophobia. But yet, they are quite willing to accept that that law should be imposed upon Christians and Jews.
Okay, now let me respond. I can do exactly what he did here. I can do the exact same thing.
Do it then.
Okay, in the Old Testament, it says, kill the donkey, kill the baby, kill the woman that had sex here, and keep the virgin girl for yourself. The Spanish Inquisition, when they killed the Muslims and they killed the Jews, they followed the Bible. This guy doesn't follow the Bible. The Spanish, yeah, they follow the Bible better than him. The Spanish were the true Christians. Their Spanish Inquisition was the reality.
Show me the Inquisition in the Bible.
One second.
Show me the Inquisition.
Don't interrupt me. Now, he says something.
I'm just
asking. Ask them Christian manners.
Where's the Inquisition
this
in the Bible?
This is the manners of Christianity. Why are you heckling me for? Now, listen, yeah. He says something about Zakat. He lied and he exposed his ignorance here about the Zakat tax. We believe in Islam, yeah. If somebody says, I'm a Muslim and I refuse to pay the zakat, then you can kill him. He has to be killed by the state, not by us. But in a state, yeah, he will be put in the court system and he'll go through the judicial process and he'll be executed. That is why the Ridda Wars, the first battles here that happened in Islam, was over zakat. There was Muslims, after the Prophet ﷺ passed away, yeah, there were some Muslims, they said, we're not paying any zakat. And then there was battles that was fought over that issue. About you have to pay the zakat, you have to pay the tax. So he's just trying to say, yeah, if the Christians and the Jews, they don't pay the jizya, that they go in the judicial process, that they're gonna get killed. But it's the same with the Muslims. If the Muslim doesn't pay the zakat tax and he refuses in the judicial process, he will meet the same fate as the Christian and the Jew. And this guy never talks about the Inquisition. The Spanish Inquisition was no mercy, no tolerance. No tolerance whatsoever. Us, okay, the light is too much, man. The light is in my eye. But he says about us, yeah, okay, Muslims, you weren't that tolerant. You weren't tolerant enough. You weren't nice enough. But when they came with the power, there was no niceness. There was no kindness. There was no mercy of Jesus or whatever. It was just a sword. And it wasn't like, oh, pay tax. If the Christians came to Spain, yeah, and they said to the Muslims, pay tax and you can live here. All the Muslims will pay the tax. We don't have any issue. But they said, forget tax, we're just gonna kill you. because you're heretics. We're going to cut off your head. We're going to burn you alive. Exactly. That was the Christian way. And us, the way we dealt with it was, you're a Christian, live here. Have your church. You're allowed to drink alcohol. Nice. In Spain, you're allowed alcohol.
Nice.
You're allowed pork.
To the Romanians.
You're allowed pork. You're even allowed.
Ask the Spanish Christians if that's how they experience Islam.
Ask the Jews. The Jews were allowed. Hey, the Jews.
Talk to the Greeks. See if they think you're right.
The Jews were allowed in the Holy Land.
Ask the Hungarians if they. This is how they experience Islam.
Interrupting me. See, he's interrupting me. Yeah, but look. Ask the Jews, yeah, they'll tell you they were allowed to live in Jerusalem in peace. They were allowed.
That's why they've all fled the Muslim world and are now living in Israel.
He was a Jewish scholar in Spain. Maimonides.
See, but now Zionism, there's Jews that hate Zionism. They actually reject Zionism, the Zionist state. And they'll say, look, we used to live in peace with the Muslims. But you guys are now trying to create trouble. Okay, but even the Jewish scripture doesn't condemn that stuff about Zionism. Not all Jews are Zionists, okay? Don't promote that.
I'm not. You are.
How am I promoting that?
I'm not promoting it. I've never mentioned Zionism at all in this debate.
Yes, you said, because now they're living in Israel and the Jews. I never said that. Jews don't want Israel. Most Jews are against the state of Israel. Anyway, but the Christians, yeah, they genocided the Jews. They genocided, and I'm telling you right now, yeah, that is Christianity.
Shall I reply?
No, let me tell you why it's Christianity. Yeah?
Shall I reply?
I haven't even told you why.
All right, your final point, go on.
Because I'll tell you why, because the Bible, the Old Testament,
yep.
The God of the Old Testament, yeah, was Jesus. And Jesus is the one who told you to do those stuff by kill them, the babies, the women, the children, the oxes, the animals, everything. Yeah?
Yep.
And keep the virgin girl for yourself, sex,
yeah.
Okay. And then he admitted, he said, yeah, okay.
No, I'm just moving you along.
But no longer.
I'm not agreeing with you.
Okay, but now, yeah, okay, it's for you to say, and then what the Bible also says, not one tittle of the law will pass, okay? Like you cannot, you have to affirm the whole of the Old Testament,
okay.
All the rules.
Is that your final point? Okay. So the point is, the brother doesn't understand the Christian faith. And sadly, despite the fact that you have actually professionals in the Islamic Dawah team who are being paid by groups in Pakistan, right? They, after years and years of debating Christians, have never been able to engage with this very simple point, that Christians believe in a new covenant. And we believe we are a community of that new covenant, which means that we do not follow the old covenant. The old covenant is not something that we have to follow. There are many things in the Old Testament that we see as history. We accept that they are there. And we accept that God even commanded brutal things in a brutal age. We don't believe that they're applicable today. By contrast, the Muslim community has the brutality of Muhammad, the brutality of raping female captives, the brutality of the slave trade. The brutality of waging jihad. Now, let us look at something. He is trying to say that a system of laws, such as the Sharia and its practice towards Christians and Jews, in the way that it treats them, is somehow good, even though it forbids Christians to celebrate their festivals properly, it forbids Muslims to become Christians, it allows for the murder, the public execution of those who choose to become Christians, it allows for slave trading. This apparently is somehow better than what we have now. He thinks that we Christians are bound to Old Testament law. We're not.
You condemn it.
Our Christian practice is based upon the imitation of Christ.
But do you condemn it?
And how he represents the Father.
The evil of the Old Testament.
This we do as individuals. we do it as a collective community, and then when we have opportunity, we do so in society as well. Now, he wants to heckle me all the way through my presentation.
He heckled me.
All the way through my presentation.
So,
Andalusia was nonetheless, despite everything what he says, an invasion and occupation of Christian land. An invasion and occupation of Christian land. But maybe that's not good enough for him. Look at what happened in Eastern Europe. In Eastern Europe, Muslims invaded Christian lands and they took Christian children as slaves. They indoctrinated him.
He's talking about
and then put them into the Janissaries.
Propaganda.
He says it's propaganda.
Just like the Jews.
He says it's lies. So I challenge all of you watching on YouTube to go and Google the Janissaries and see what you find out in history. And you will see that despite the fact he's now comparing me to Hitler, despite that fact, that I am actually speaking factually. And he is the one who's pushing propaganda and lies.
What lies?
Now,
Inquisition is a factual
let's
thing.
Talk about the Inquisition. He says that the Inquisition had no mercy. What he doesn't know about the Inquisition is that before the Inquisition arrived in any town, it was announced that it was coming. And there was a month of grace. A month of grace in which every person had the opportunity to come forward to confess whatever sin they had been guilty of and it would be forgiven of them. 1 month. He said it was there was no mercy in the Inquisition. I've just demonstrated an example of that mercy. Furthermore, what he doesn't realize is the fact that the existence of the Jewish community within Europe for hundreds of years, for thousands of years, since the time of Constantine and onwards, demonstrates that the Christian faith did have tolerance.
You were persecuted.
It's interesting to note that in Constantinople, the very first mosque built in Constantinople was built by the Christians for Muslim prisoners of war. What he didn't tell you is that when Muslims invaded Palestine, that one of their first acts was to ride horses into the Holy Sepulchre so that their horses could defecate inside the church. What he didn't tell you is that when Muslims invaded Eastern Europe, they banned the ringing of bells. They forbid Christians to practice their religion. They forcibly converted churches to mosques. He said it's a lie, so look what they did to Hagia Sophia. I am not the one dealing in propaganda. They are. They are the one that are lying. They are the one that are making up facts. Now, I am not saying that everything that happened in Christian history is wonderful or brilliant. I'm not trying to argue that the Inquisition was some thing that we could do today.
No.
What I am pointing out is that your characterization of the Inquisition is counterfactual. Your characterization of Andalusia is counterfactual. The fact of the matter is that the only people that experience the tolerance that you're talking about are a few academics within Cordoba, within the Islamic Andalusia. The common person was a victim in Andalusia. That's why when the Christians launched raids in Andalusia, the Christian populations in the Caliphate fled with the Christians that were raiding the Caliphate back to Christian lands. If it was so good, why didn't they want to stay? Why didn't they want to stay? They had no choice. Now, the fact of the matter is that I want to ask you this question. I want to ask you this question. Yeah, but I want to ask you a question. I want to ask you a question. If the British government imposed a law today that stopped Muslims from practicing the fullness of their religion according to their customs, and if it said that anyone who converts to Islam should be killed, And if it said that you had to pay protection money for your life and property, if they impose that law on Muslims, would you be complaining about discrimination, yes or no?
Okay, I'll let me respond now. I'm having my time to talk, and then I'll come back to your question at the end. But one second, right now I want to speak about something, yeah? You said about the Inquisition, Spanish Inquisition, yeah? That somehow it was good, or the if it was something good, yeah? That it was something tolerant, etc. Then the Jews, why did they leave? Look up the term genocide, look up the definition of genocide, yeah? Forced displacement of people is genocide. Okay, the Jews were forcibly displaced from Spain, all
like
of them.
The Armenian genocide?
And they went to, like the Serbian genocide, and they went to North Africa, okay, to Morocco,
like
to where the Muslims.
The Greeks in Turkey?
And in
Bosnia,
Palestine,
like
yeah.
In Kosovo,
exactly.
The
exactly.
Yeah, like the Christians in Kosovo. Yeah.
In Palestine, the Jewish had their own quota, the Christians had their own quota, and the Muslims had their quota.
Exactly.
And the Jews were allowed to rule themselves according to their Torah. Okay, in certain instances, and the Christians as well, according to the Bible. But us as Muslims, yeah, you talk about freedom of religion in this country, yeah, it doesn't exist. Not in the way you think of it. We had more freedom of religion, yeah, for Christians and Jews, yeah, than we have as Muslims in this country, yeah. Because us, yeah, look, if we want to rule by Sharia in certain part of this country, we're not allowed to do it. But we allowed Jews and Christians to rule by their own book.
No, in our country. No, you didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, you didn't.
I gave them, okay.
Why were Christians not allowed to do processions in the street? Wait for your turn to have a rebuttal.
Certain practices were not allowed, but when it comes to ruling, judging. No, no, when it comes to judicial process, yeah, judging, what are you going to judge by? The law of the land, that's what they all cry about, yeah. But we, when we were the rulers, yeah, we did not say the law of the land, the Sharia. That's what you're going to judge by. No, we allowed you to judge by your Bible.
That's exactly
judge by your Torah. We allowed you to do that.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I'll give the evidence for that as well. I'll put it in the comments.
That's okay.
Now,
are you
going to
answer my question?
No, one second. Let me have my time to speak. He wants to dictate my time to speak, right? What to speak about? You see this? This is called post-colonial mindset. Anyway,
no.
Don't worry about it. Yeah. That's Christian. Post-Christian colonial mindset.
No.
But let me speak, yeah?
It's called not being a dhimmi.
No. See? That's not. Listen.
It's called not being a dhimmi.
Hey, it's funny you're doing your laugh.
The Christians, innit? What are you going to dictate to me, though? I'm not dictating to you when you want
wait,
to.
Wait, you were heckling me all the way through my conversation.
No, I didn't.
Yes,
I did what you did to me. Okay? I just responded.
Are you going to answer my question?
Now, you as a Christian, turn the other cheek.
Are you going to answer my question?
Now listen, yeah. Okay, now you talk about the modern day. Yeah, you tried to talk about the modern day, right?
Yeah.
So, in the modern day, there was a Christian by the name of George Bush. Okay,
he went
to the church. He said, "I declare a crusade against Iraq." He said, "Gog and Magog is rising up from Iraq." Okay, it was not a secular war. It was a Christian religious war against Iraqi Sunni Muslims. Okay, he went there with bombs. First what happened there was embargo, and 500,000 children starved to death, and another 500,000 innocent people, Muslim women and children and men, yeah, starved to death. Okay, that was just the embargo. The second one was the invasion. Another 1 million killed. So that's 2 million people. And he talks about some little fringe terrorist group, and he's trying to put all the pressure on that, like they are the world's greatest evil.
I compared it to the Andalusian caliphate.
Not by any stretch of the imagination.
You're defending the Andalusian caliphate. I compared them to ISIS.
One second. I'm comparing you to American state, yeah? America, Christian state country, yeah? It's the first one.
It's actually a secular state.
No, but it's a Christian.
According to their constitution, religion doesn't rule government.
No,
it says that
there was never an atheist president.
It's a secular state. Not Christian.
You're interrupting me the whole time. Anyway,
there was
never an atheist president of America, ever.
Yeah, there is called Obama.
Obama was a Christian. You're racist, I think. Why? Obama was a Christian.
Bill Clinton as
Obama
well.
Obama was a Christian, okay?
Now it's like two Democrats.
Obama was a Christian, okay? And all the presidents of America were Christians. Okay.
Obama wasn't. Neither was Bill Clinton.
Oh, Obama, because he was black, that's why. Well,
I just said Bill Clinton as well.
Okay, but anyway.
Because they're Democrats.
Throw that in it. But anyway.
Yeah, you accuse everyone
of
every kind of worries.
I'm not trying to accuse you anyway. But look.
You just did.
But no worries. Christians, yeah? Okay, were the leaders of America. And they dropped nukes on Japan.
That's true.
Where did the Bible teach them about that? The Bible says, kill the babies, the women, the children. It says kill everybody. The Bible says even kill the animals. So you're using that in the head, and they nuked Japan twice.
And where was the quote? Where was the quote? When they dropped the bomb, where did they quote the Old Testament? They didn't.
And also Vietnam. Okay. And all the other wars that happened, the crusades that happened.
So.
Even colonialism, colonialism. Colonialism, slavery, chattel slavery of black people that were brought here, was justified with the Bible.
What about the African? They kept them in check
with the Bible.
Who was selling the black slaves to the white Europeans? Arab Muslims.
So no, they use the Bible though. They actually brought the Bible to them.
The Muslims were using the Quran.
Show me evidence.
I will.
Show me what evidence there were. The Muslims use the Quran, Quran to people.
I am going.
This is why you have most Christians, most black people that live in America or in Europe, they're Christians. Majority of them. Very few of them are Muslim. Or they were raised as Muslim. They weren't.
Okay.
I haven't made my final point. Those who are Muslim became Muslim. They reverted. They chose for themselves the religion.
Not really.
But those majority of them, they're the ones who they're born with Christian, they're born with their Christian names, like Simon.
Just like Christians in Saudi Arabia who have left Islam to become Christian. They chose their own religion as well. This is going to be my final point. He has not dealt with the issues that I raised.
I compared
Andalusia, the Islamic caliphate that he accepts as being Islamic, to ISIS. People heard the comparison on the video, it's on record. They can decide whether it is a false equivalence or not. Incidentally, the Islamic Caliphate of Andalusia fought other Muslims, and ISIS fought other Muslims. Just one more comparison.
What? Okay.
Now,
with that logic,
it says in the Quran, fight those who believe not in Allah nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden which hath been forbidden by Allah, his prophet, nor acknowledge the religion of truth of the people of the book, until they pay the jizya with willing submission and feel themselves subdued. Other translations have it as humiliated. Now, the fact of the matter is, I asked him a question, he said he was going to get to it at the end, and he never dealt with the question.
I will get to it.
So the question is, if the British government, or any government in the world, brought in a system of laws that restricted the Muslims from practicing their belief according to their customs in this country, that prohibited Muslims, prohibited people from entering Islam under sentence of death, that stopped Muslims from, that forced Muslims to pay a protection racket that would mean the end of their life or property on account of their belief, I am quite sure that the Islamic Dawah team here at Speaker's Corner would be screaming Islamophobia, Islamic prejudice. And yet, hypocritically, we have a member of the Islamic Dawah team trying to justify these same discriminatory practices that are practiced by the Andalusian Caliphate during the 700 years of its occupation of Spain and are directly comparable to the actions of ISIS in Syria and Iraq, and he's trying to justify one while could justify it in one place whilst condemning it in another. And I would leave this question with all of you on YouTube. Which one gives us a better way of life? A system of laws based upon discrimination, based upon religion and gender and economic status, or a religious ethic that talks about love your neighbor as yourself, love your brothers and sisters and serve them as I have served you, love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul and strength, love your enemy. The Christian faith alone gives us an ethic and a call to a kind of character that develops good communities and good societies. Sharia law, by comparison, establishes a supremacist system where Muslims are at the top, Christians and Jews are underneath, and then every poor sucker who isn't a Christian or a Jew is at risk of death directly. Now,
it's my turn now.
Not yet. No, not yet. You talked to Weil.
No, you said you're going to have a final point.
You talked to Weil. He denied the martyrs of Cordoba. He denied the fact that there was anti-Jewish pogroms in Spain. He ignored all of that. He kept talking about things like the Inquisition and the wars of America. America, by its own constitution, publicly declares that it is not a Christian state. The Constitution of America is a secular constitution. Once again, the man is dealing in propaganda, rhetoric. He is not dealing with facts. I call all of you who are watching and all of you who are listening to follow the evidence, not the rhetoric. The evidence is Islam as a system practiced by Muhammad, practiced by the Andalusian Caliphate, practiced by the Ottoman Caliphate, and if you want to or not, practiced by ISIS, is a system that leads to discrimination, persecution, and death. And that is why, as a Christian who is called to uphold justice, called to pursue justice, not just for myself, but for my neighbours and enemies as well, I am obliged morally to oppose Sharia law. I am obliged morally to oppose Islam. Not because I don't love Muslims, but because Islam is a system that it creates injustice. For instance, through the use of the slave trade, which he says I was lying about.
Are you gonna finish? Are you just gonna, look, this is a monologue.
Sorry.
This guy, you spoke longer than me.
Do you want me to give you evidence?
Afterwards.
Do you want me to? Okay, I'm just gonna read this evidence. I won't comment. I'm just gonna read the evidence because you said I was making it up.
Go ahead.
Slaves in Islam. Okay? This is Sahih al-Muslim, number 19, 4345. There's your reference. I'm not making it up. Quite a long passage. It has been narrated on the authority of Salama, who said he fought against the Fazara, and Abu Bakr was the commander over us. He had been appointed by the Messenger of Allah when we were only at an hour's distance from the water of the enemy. Abu Bakr ordered us to attack. We made a halt during the last part of the night to rest, and then we attacked from all sides and reached their watering place where a battle was fought. Some of the enemies were killed and some were taken prisoners. I saw a group of persons that consisted of women and children. I was afraid that they should reach the mountain before me and thus escape. So I shot an arrow between them and the mountain. When they saw the arrow, they stopped. So I brought them, driving them along. Among them were women from Banu Fazara. She was wearing a leather coat. With her was her daughter, who was one of the prettiest girls in Arabia. I drove them along until I brought them to Abu Bakr, who bestowed that girl upon me as a prize. So we arrived in Medina. I had not yet disrobed her when the Messenger of Allah met me in the street and said, "Give me that girl, O Salama." I said, "Messenger of Allah, she has fascinated me." I had not yet disrobed her when on the next day the Messenger of Allah met me in the street and he said, "O Salama, give me that girl. May God bless your father." I said, "She is for you." The Messenger of Allah, "I have not yet disrobed her." The Messenger of Allah sent her to the people of Mecca and surrendered her as ransom for a number of Muslims who had been kept as prisoners in Mecca. There's your evidence.
You said your comments.
Slavery.
You just said you want comments.
And rape.
I really don't lie.
Okay, slavery so and rape.
Don't lie though. You said you want comments.
I
anyway.
Have not yet disrobed her.
So, was he looking?
He intended to rape
it's
her.
It's rotting me now. He said first, "I won't comment about it." And then he said, "I'm going to let you speak." And now he's retorting me. Anyway. So this guy, he said about, he made so many points. And he wants you to ask all of them. Anyway. No, let me finish it, yeah? Be our Christian manners. So you said about, what did he say? He said about the Sharia, yeah? He said if the person doesn't pay tax, yeah, that they're going to be killed in the Islamic system. That's so evil. But in this system, yeah, in the UK, if I say to the UK Queen, yeah, or the government, I'm not going to pay tax, I'm going to be put in prison. If I keep to say I'm not going to pay tax, I refuse, I'm going to be put in prison. I'm going to be imprisoned in it for life until I agree to pay tax, yes or no? That's true. So life imprisonment, death penalty, what's like, I'm finished, yeah? I'm not finished. What else did he say? He made another point. I had it in my head. Comparing ISIS to the Islamic government in Spain. He said ISIS and that government, they did similar things, therefore they're the same. I said to him, okay, I could use that same logic, that same argumentation, yeah, against you and say you're Hitler. You're white. Just like Hitler. Are you listening? I'm gonna say to him, you're white just like Hitler was white. You have blue eyes just like Hitler had blue eyes. You're European just like Hitler was European. Okay, you have a hatred against a small group of people who are a minority in the land, just like Hitler. So I could say, using this argumentation, yeah, you are Hitler. Does that make it right? It doesn't make it right, does it? It's false equivalence. This idiot here doesn't know the difference between false equivalence here and making a genuine point. Okay? And if we're going to say about small groups or terrorist groups here, the LRA, the Lord's Resistance Army, who are Christians, who are terrorists in Africa, and there's other Christian groups as well. IRA, who are Catholic, who are bombing us all. There are many terrorist groups who are Christian in Africa, in Asia, etc. Okay, that doesn't mean do we start attributing that to Christianity, saying Christianity, therefore they're the real Christians, all of you are fake Christians. This guy, he lives in this crazy environment. I think he's a radical, to be honest. I think he's one of those far-right Christians. And he says he has a hatred for minorities. That's all it comes down to.
I am obliged morally to oppose Sharia law. I am obliged morally to oppose Islam. Not because I don't love Muslims, but because Islam is a system that creates injustice.